Hello everyone, it's Kick here, and in today's episode we have Google causing panic among governments and IT giants by announcing that it will distribute AI training worldwide. Apple has decided to develop domestic robots instead of an electric car. A famous circus has replaced animals with robots. The electric car IM Motors autonomously navigates obstacles at a speed of 71 km/h, a new technology allowing drones to charge from power lines, and Musk has announced that up to 3 generations of Starship vessels are planned. All this and much more right now. Let's get started. The race for power in the field of neural networks is picking up insane speed. Recently, Microsoft and OpenAI have teamed up to build a super powerful supercomputer for a staggering $100 billion. In response, Google has made a bold move by introducing a decentralized system that uses servers around the world for AI training. This method, developed by Google's DeepMind division, has literally made everyone scratch their heads. Using the DiPaco algorithm, the corporation employs geographically distributed computing resources for AI training. By utilizing capacities around the world, DeepMind intends to scale neural networks to unprecedented sizes, bypassing the limitations of centralized systems. This solution not only challenges the multi-billion dollar investments of competitors, but also regulatory measures of countries. Monitoring model development is convenient by tracking major data centers where they are based. However, with data processing being parallelized, it's harder to track what information fills the base of chatbots. Moreover, this breakthrough method makes the creation of super intelligent AIs accessible almost to everyone. Thus, many market players besides Google have a chance to shake the oligopoly and accelerate progress in the neural network industry. This decentralized approach to AI training and development not only speeds up innovations, but also presents new challenges and questions to the market. If the use of decentralized systems grows, how will it affect competition and data security? Will the world of AI become more open and accessible, or will we see new forms of monopolization and control? Discuss these questions in the comments and share your opinion about the future of neural networks and artificial intelligence. Do you think the era of decentralized AI will reach new heights, or will it lead to unexpected complexities and risks? Apple is exploring the possibility of entering the personal robotics market, which should become a new large-scale project after the cancelled development of the electric car. The company has conceived to create an autonomous robot capable of performing household tasks, such as washing dishes and following the user. However, this will require solving complex engineering challenges, and it will take years. According to sources, Apple has already developed an advanced desktop robotic device for a smart display. It is still unknown whether at least one of these projects will be launched into mass production. But one thing is clear, Tim is looking for new sources of income. Apple claims that the robotic smart display has been under development for several years, but management is unsure whether to develop this direction at all. One of the possibilities of such a device could be to imitate the head movements of the interlocutor, such as nodding, during a FaceTime call. However, the company doubts that people will be willing to pay huge money for such a device. Additionally, technical issues related to the balance of the drive have arisen during development. By the way, Cupertino will not be the first company trying to enter the home robotics market. In 2021, Amazon introduced it to the home robot Astro at a price of $1,600. The company is not rushing to increase its production, therefore the device remains a niche product. Last year, Amazon introduced a business version of the robot to work as a security guard. What do you think? Will the autonomous robot assistant become a new necessity or remain just an expensive toy for technology enthusiasts? Leave your comments. We are very interested to read. Now let's move to the circus. Yes, you heard right. The Ringling Brothers Circus, founded in 1871, was once the largest and most famous in the world, until it closed 7 years ago. This year it has returned, but in an updated show there are no animals, as they are now replaced by robots. This will surely please animal rights advocates. For example, before the audience performs a robot dog Go One from Unitary Robotics, the electronic circus performer was decorated with pink fur, and a springtail was attached to it. The robot is controlled via a remote control resembling a drone controller. Notably, anyone interested can buy Go One starting at 25 Fernando. This decision is not only innovative and original, but also effective. For example, robots simplify the staff's care for the circus, eliminating the need for feeding and maintaining animals. Moreover, robots are not subject to stress and do not require training. They just need to be programmed. Let's move on. The Chinese company IM Motors, a division of electric vehicles SAIC, showed how the newly available sedan L6 on autopilot passes the Moose test, navigating a hypothetical obstacle at a speed of 71 km/h. The L6 model was released in the Chinese market on April 8th. IM Motors aims to attract significant attention to it, given the fierce competition in the Chinese electric vehicle market. The manufacturer plans to equip the car with a steering rear suspension, which will allow turning on a limited area or moving diagonally in crab mode. In one of the versions of this model, the electric car may be equipped with a solid-state battery, which provides a range of more than 1,000 kilowatt hours. Now let's take to the skies. Venus Aerospace showed the first demonstration flight of a drone with a rocket rotary detonation engine. The unmanned aerial vehicle in the form of a winged missile weighing 140 kilowatts and measuring 2.4 meters was dropped from an airplane at an altitude of 3,700 mm. On a hydrogen peroxide engine, the drone developed a speed of 0.9 Mach and flew 16.1 km/h. It is reported that the engine operated at 80% thrust, therefore the task to overcome the 1 Mach mark was not set. Acceleration to a speed of over 1 Mach will be carried out in subsequent launches with the inclusion of a rocket rotary detonation engine, which this time was simply present on board the unmanned vehicle. In the future, Venus Aerospace plans to create a hypersonic spaceplane or aircraft that will be able to accelerate to a speed of 9 Mach and deliver passengers to any point on Earth in about an hour or so, but this will definitely not happen tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. Meanwhile, you can watch a video of how the model of an unmanned vehicle with a promising engine flies. A group of engineers from the University of Southern Denmark has developed technology that will allow drones to charge from power lines. When the drone's program registers a decrease in battery charge, the device, using radar and cameras, starts looking for a nearby power line and heads to it by the shortest trajectory. The clamps work purely mechanically, without electrical components. The magnetic clamping system provides reliable fastening. Hanging on the wires, the drone charges by induction. The technology trials took place in a very picturesque place near the Hans Christian Andersen Airport. The drone, weighing 4.3 kilograms, Kilo inspected the condition of the power lines for 2 hours, replenishing its battery 5 times. The developers were pleased with the results, but plan to increase the system's reliability and test it in more remote regions and less favorable weather conditions. Chinese company EHang has received a license for the mass production of flying taxis EH216S. The company has already started accepting pre-orders for these aircraft at a price of $330,000. Outside China, such a flying taxi will cost $410,000, but EHang received the license for their mass production only recently. Chinese regulators, after a phased certification of EHang's products, recognized that the company can produce them on a serial basis. The company claims that it received permission to produce flying taxis first in the world. The company also plans to expand in markets outside of China, which will also be preceded by multi-stage certification in different countries. The aircraft, equipped with 16 electric motors with blades, can lift 2 passengers and their luggage into the air by a vertical trajectory and move them at a cruising speed of up to 100 km/h for 21 minutes. During this time, according to the manufacturer, the aircraft will be able to move away from the takeoff point by 35 km. Battery recharging takes 120 minutes. The maximum speed is 130 km/h, and the flight altitude can reach 3,000 aerobliferens. The aircraft is controlled automatically, so both passenger seats can be occupied by clients ready to pay for the carrier's services. And of course, what's kick without space? Let's start with NASA. According to the Artemis mission roadmap, astronauts will land on the moon in 2026, and in 2030, NASA plans to deliver wheeled transport there. The agency has already selected 3 contractors whose rovers may go to the satellite. The development of the rovers is being carried out by companies Intuitive Machines, Lunar Outpost, and Venturi Astrolab. They have already signed contracts with NASA and started work on the machines. So far, models have only been shown in conceptual images. The rovers must operate in conditions of reduced gravity and low temperature, down to 173°C. Their task is to transport astronauts and equipment. Also included in the requirements is a remote control system. It is noted that during transport downtimes, the manufacturer using its rover and remote control can perform its tasks, including commercial ones. Initially, the contractors will develop a rover project that meets NASA's requirements. Subsequently, the agency will select one of them after production, send it to the moon for testing, and later provide the chosen model to its astronauts. And here's Elon Musk, standing at the test site of his space company, stating his intention to increase the frequency of launches and the payload capacity of the Starship rocket. Musk announced that the 4th test of the Starship spacecraft and the Super Heavy booster will take place in about a month. Approximately the same time frame in mid-March was announced by SpaceX President Gwynne Shotwell at the Satellite 2024 conference. The flight is scheduled for early May after obtaining official permission from the US Federal Aviation Administration. If the flight takes place, it will be less than 2 months between the 2 Starship launches. This time, unlike previous tests, SpaceX will attempt to return the Super Heavy booster to Earth intact. In the course of landing the stage, it will be caught by a virtual tower in the Gulf of Mexico. The success of this operation will bring the company closer to the stated goal, a fully returnable launch system. To increase the frequency of launches, SpaceX will accelerate the production of Starship. By the March launch, the company claimed it had built 4 ready launch systems, Starship plus Super Heavy. By the end of the year, their number will reach about 10, Musk promised. Next year, production will increase increase even more. For these purposes, the company will build a gigantic factory near the launch site. Additionally, a second launch pad will appear at Starbase, another one at Cape Canaveral in the middle of next year. Subsequently, it will become the main platform for commercial launches, while at the Starbase Cosmodrome, new rockets will be assembled and tested. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay updated on high-tech news. Peace to your home.